The Library of Alexandria, which was said to house logs and codexes from the first times, was burned to the ground, along with the ties to our past. After the crucifixion of Jesus and his followers, an effort was made by the Roman Empire to shut down any ties to his teachings. The teachings of Jesus would survive through secret societies and hidden networks. Any symbol regarding sacred geometry would be associated with devil worship, as a form of propaganda to psychologically manipulate the masses into believing that what was being done was a good thing in the name of God. And, after about a century, the Gnostics formulated. The Gnostics were one of the first forms of Christianity, possibly the first. We cannot know for certain due to the manipulation of history. We covered their beliefs in the previous episode, the belief that the Abrahamic God is actually a demiurge disguised as God, while the true God is trapped within the prison of the physical dimension, trapped within each body. You can imagine how this was received by the bureaucracy, who adopted the now official version of Christianity. The Roman Empire collapsed, and the Byzantine Empire took its place, aka the Eastern Roman Empire. All Gnostics were accused of heresy. They were labeled as devil worshippers, pagans, and blasphemers. All of their documents and knowledge was burned in the fires. They were publicly executed. For hundreds of years onward, the Roman Catholic Church controlled Rome with an iron fist. They ensured that the masses were uneducated. Anyone caught reading the Bible would be burned to the cross. In fact, anyone who is not an authoritative person who was caught reading in general would be executed. This period of history was known as the Dark Age. 800 years after the death of Jesus, a new group called the Cathars formulated. They were reviving the Gnostic belief systems. Again, I want to emphasize, the Roman Catholic Church could not afford anyone questioning their authority, so they would torture and kill anyone who dared to question them. Giordano Bruno, for instance, was a man who questioned their authority. He questioned their Bible and their God. Despite the fact that people ridiculed him, he would never give up preaching. He would read about the ancient Egyptians and the Gnostics. And by doing so, he was a rebel against the system. A system that vilifies anything or anyone that looks different or has a different perspective on the creation of the universe. They captured Giordano and tortured him for years, pressing him to submit to their ways. He wouldn't. And for that, he was burned alive. Burned alive for questioning the system. It became clear for some that the empire was not serving the best interests of the people. It was serving the best interests for those in power, those heavily invested in the suppression of knowledge and information. So, the conquests and expansions ensued. The objective for certain crusaders were to find and eliminate any ties to the truth about the nature of reality. The only other center of knowledge left in the Eastern world was located in Baghdad, Iraq, which got incidentally ransacked by the Mongolians during this period. Acts such as these forced secret societies to form in order to preserve the knowledge of the ancients. They would be hunted down by the crusaders, but never fully eliminated. These unsung heroes of history will never be known, yet their actions have a direct effect on us today.